from UIC Pavilion, where the Panthers are in the championship game of the City Consolation Playoffs. Panthers are taking on Wells. If you notice, we have a very cool stadium. I'll take a quick tour for our setup. Isn't that exciting, y'all? Set that down. So we are in the big stadium tonight for this playoff. Ooh, it's getting excited.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
As you can see, we have one.
And welcome once again to Credit Union Warren Arena for the Chicago Public League Boys Varsity Basketball Blue and White Division Championship Final. Tonight's matchup features the Von Steuben Panthers versus the Wells Raiders. And now, ladies and gentlemen, introducing the starting lineup for the Panthers. At guard, number one, Axel Rivera. At guard, number two, Owen Rivera.
The brothers.
At guard, number three, Melvin Holder Alvarado. At forward, number five, Dubim Duboye. And the man in the middle for the Panthers, number 21, Kevin Anthony. The head coach of the Panthers is Marvin Williams. And now, introducing the starting lineup for the Wells Raiders. At guard, number one, Tashaun Fountain. Number two, Jamari Hill. Playing the wing, number 15, Amari Brown. At forward, number 21, Robert Showalter. And the man in the middle for the Raiders, number 24, Brandon Harris. The head coach of the Raiders is Michael Horton. Today's officials will be Joe Slayton, Ronnie Brigham, and Ron Moncrief.
Kevin's name twice.
down, but we do have the first
score is 4-2 in favor of the Raiders, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, so we are coming back to the score. Let's see what is in our way. And we have a missed shot from the corner. Wells with the rebound, heading back down the other end. And Vaughn is in their 1-3-1 zone, and a quick foul.
Ball home against the Panthers, number 2, Owen Rivera.
And Wells attacking at the center, kicks out to the wing for a 3-point shot. So Wells sticking in a full court 1-3-1, it looks like full court press. And Vaughn passing all the way through to this end, almost loses it but keeps it. And Wells falls back into their zone defense half court. We look inside of the big man, isn't able to get it. Mel able to save it, he was on the line and they see it. It's gonna be turnover, Vaughn Stevens.
Raiders basketball.
So again, the score is 7-2, Wells in the lead. Under 6 minutes remaining in this first quarter. So Wells dribbling into the zone, kick it out again for a 3-point attempt, no good. And Owen up for the rebound, fighting to get it out to Mel. And coming down on offense. Mel looking to Little Rivera, Little Rivera driving, kicks it out. And we're gonna set the offense back up. And a nice pass inside and up for two, and he hits it. So Vaughn still trailing, score 7-4. Another 3-point attempt by Wells, no good. Owen picking up the rebound, tries to get it to Mel, and it's gonna be hit out of bounds. It's gonna stay Vaughn Steuben basketball.
Ladies and gentlemen, the score is currently 7-4 in favor of the Raiders.
So 4 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in this first quarter. And Axel at the top tries to get it inside, but Wells gets that steal, and they're heading quickly on offense to the other end for a quick 2-point
Jabari Hill. Timeout.
Bringing the score. 9-4, Vaughn trailing by 5. Heading.
This is a 30-second timeout.
So we have 4 minutes and 26 seconds in this first quarter. Sorry about the angle. I wish I had more today, but we're working with
hey
my
fans,
cell phone.
Take out your phones and scan the QR code on the video board. Access to today's digital program. Get team information, championship matchups, and more. And you're all just a click away at cpsathletics.com. The score is currently 9-4.
All right, so we come out of that timeout, trying to break this press that they're putting on. And Mel takes the reins at the top of the key. Wells in their press. And takes it himself to the hole and makes the bucket and fouled on it. Bringing the score 9-6, and he will try to make a 3-point play out of the deal.
He's at the line with one shot to attempt to complete a 3-point play.
like I have an echo, ladies and gentlemen. And he hits it.
It's a 3-point play.
All right, Vaughn falling back and sticking with that 1-3-1 zone that we've seen a lot in the end of this season. Kev with the block, he says, not in my UIC house, and hits it out of bounds. So Wells will take it out underneath the basket. So Wells kicks it out to the top of the key as they set up their offense in another 3-point attempt. No good, but they are able to get the rebound, but it's blocked out of bounds once again. So Wells is going to stay on offense.
Raiders basketball.
And the brothers coming out at the top of the key, and this was, I think, the fourth try.
The basket counts.
We are not rebounding, so we got
to make
sure
that
we're boxing out
and rebounding.
We
need 20
shot attempts on one turn at the basket, so he hits the basket, misses the free throw. The score is now 11-7. And Owen's going to take it to the hole. No foul is called. And we're heading back the other direction. And back around the horn. Quick passes by Well. Kev goes for the block and gets called on it. You saw that swing of the arm. No matter what, every time, even if no contact is made, and you know if the ref sees your arm swing, they're going to call it out.
The Panthers
So number two will be
Jabari Hill with the line for the Raiders. Two shots. First,
and it
rattles
in. So it's 12-7 with 3 minutes and 16 seconds remaining in this first quarter.
Second basket goal.
He hits them both. Sticking with the full court. And Kev bringing it down. Ooh, nice pass inside going up. No foul called again. And a long pass down out of the hands of Axel, and 2 points, easy conversion on the other end. So it's now 15-7 with about 2 minutes and 45 seconds. We're coming back this way. Oh, man. And the pass was up and over his head, and he was not able to bring it back down, and he steps out of bounds. It's going to be Wells basketball. And it is now a 10-point game, 17-7. Vaughn looks like they have some jitters they need to get out. They're doing a good job of feeding the inside, but their shots are just not falling tonight, ladies and gentlemen. With 2 minutes remaining in this first quarter, Wells moving the basketball well. It looks like a little bit of a travel, no call. And again, they're getting a second chance, but this time they're camping out in the lane. So turnover Wells with a 3-second call.
Panthers basketball.
And I don't know what they just called our team, but we're definitely not the partners. Passes are not going to be there all night. We're going to have to start using some ball fakes. and they're in a zone. They're not in a man-to-man. Owen shoots the basket for three, but it's no good again, and we're heading back the other direction. So 1 minute, 13 seconds remaining in this quarter. The score is 17-7. And Wells steps on the line.
Panthers with step ball.
Nice take by Owen, and again, another miss. This is not like him, but we do get the rebound. I think he has all of our points tonight. Oh no, Kevin has two. So it is 17-9. And with this ball movement, it is really tiring out our boys. And they're gonna hold the ball and try to get the last possession of the quarter with 14 seconds remaining. They should probably hang tight at that three-point line because they're making huge shifts and just wearing themselves out. That was a travel again, no call. Layup miss, but they get another chance again. And that'll come up again. That is the end of the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen.
This is the end of the first period.
Wells
Lakers 17, Boston Panthers 9. All right, fans. You know them and you can't help but to love them. So please welcome to the floor the Wells Cheer Team. Once again, everybody, please show your love for the ladies of the Wells Cheer Squad.
Comes up with a rebound, attacking the center, kicks it out. Well, should have maybe been. He does have a stutter step in there that they're not calling.
Take a shot,
and Mo is in the game.
respects skip ball.
And this time, that's a mistake by Wells. Drives in, gets into trouble, but is able to get it back out, and they're back at the top of the key to set up their offense. Looks like Bondo has switched to a man-to-man defense to turn things around a little bit. Let's see if we can get a stop here. Wells is continuing to play that full court press. Mo taking it to the hole all the way, misses the layup though, and they're heading back the other direction.
Hey fans, sportsmanship is the number one priority of the Chicago Public League, and we are proud to partner with to promote the importance of sportsmanship throughout the district. Scan the QR code on the video board to learn more.
Taking it to the hole, looking out to Kev. Kev at the top of the key for three. Another miss. Man, our shots are just not falling tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We have a foul called. Looks like a hook or a hand check. And Wells will take it out at half court.
Ball called against number 11, Muhammad Nadir.
Interesting decision by 15, beats Sarglare, but then does a little turnaround and comes back out. Oh, all right. I was gonna say, that guy's being a punk. And he gets teed up for being a punk. Running his mouth. Good job, sir, you got a layup. People make those. I'm sorry, I don't like when people are jerks.
The Raiders, number 15, Amari Brown. Melvin Holder Maldonado at the line for the Panthers.
And that guy, Mel, who's always clutch, makes his first free throw of the technical foul. Because that's what he does. He makes his free throws. So we have a score of 30-11. And it's also going to be Panther basketball because you can't be a jerk in basketball. And a nice pass by Kev, but unfortunately it got tied up.
Jamal.
And the possession area.
Hector's possession.
Von Steuben. And Kev taking it in is going to get hit on the take. And he'll be shooting too.
Foul called against the Raiders, number 24, Brandon Harris.
A little short, gotta bend those knees. Hey, use your legs, Kev, use your legs.
Kevin Anthony is at the line for the Panthers. One shot.
Second shot is good. Kev gets the board. A pick and roll. Mel goes to Mo in the corner, and Mel. Hopefully it keeps on rolling. And the score is 30-15 with just under 4 minutes remaining in this half. And Vaughn still sticking in this man-to-man. Nobody there on the outside. And an easy bucket for Wells. When you play man-to-man, you definitely need to still help each other out. And pass over to Owen. Owen takes it and kicks it out to Mel. Looks into Kev. Kev kicks it to Owen. Owen takes it to the hole, tries to lob it into his friend, but was stopped, and Wells is on the run again. Shots to fall. We have a whistle. And the whistle is going to be on Wells. It's going to be Von Steubenbeck.
Ball pulled against the Raiders, number 21, Robert Schulte. Panthers basketball.
And they're going to play a full court man-to-man. Oh gosh, Tech is not ready for that pass. They are playing a man-to-man defense. Mel going all the way and just hit in the face. And he'll be going to the line. So a minute to play with a score of 34 to 15 in this first half.
Melvin Porter Maldonado at the line.
Oh, that is not like him. Rattles out. Let's go, Mel. Here we go. Your shot now. Your shot. Got it, kid.
The second shot is good.
Vaughn also in a man-to-man defense. Ah, see the ball. Oh, Kev, you definitely hit him. Kevin surprised that that was a foul, even though he used his entire body to take him out.
All called against the Panthers, number 21, Kevin Anthony. Amari Brown of the line for the Raiders. Two shots. First basket goal.
So there's about 45 seconds remaining in this half. Currently the score is 16 to 35. Number 15 has one more.
Second basket goal.
Taking it up, wasn't able to get it. Wells heading the other direction. Mo, though, able to slow it down. 30 seconds to go. Ooh, almost tripped him up. And behind, Mel coming back this way. 25 seconds. Mel really hustling, takes it up, and Kevin puts it up. Sometimes I feel like he's making up all boys' names. And that will lead us into the half, ladies and gentlemen, with a score.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is halftime. What's the score? Wells Raiders 36, Von Steubenbeck 18. Tonight's contestant is Demetrius. So all right, Demetrius, we've got 30 seconds on the clock for you now. So take your mark, get set, and go! Free throw is good. Thank you.
I was like, my friend over there. like, give her a wristband? I'm like, no. She's like, you need to have a wristband to sit on the court. And I'm like, what do I have one? She's like, you need two, but you need to be on the wrist. I'm on the wrist, no worries. And so then that's why I went up and got my
wrist. Right.